So I had a great idea today, so with the incoming Pyro update, I decided, hey, you know what? You remember those community projects? Now you're probably wondering, oh, which one you thought of, right? And the first one that came to mind was Frontline. So for the people that don't know what Frontline is, it has a ton of maps like these ones here. There's weapons. There's like custom models here, which are just pretty cool. Like, see, look at this one, and this one. And look, see, like, the payload's actually like a tank. They even have a website, which is called frontline.tf. I know, right? Crazy name. And they even have like an SFM thing. Now, Crash is one of the mappers of Frontline. He's doing some pretty good work. He also has a YouTube channel where he kind of shows off his stuff. Remember this map? Well, guess what? Crash made it. He pretty much made a bunch of maps, and Valve keep accepting them. For a good reason, though. He's like really good at his work. Well, wait. Hold on for a second. Crash, how could you? You betrayed us. How could you make a jungle map? You're helping the enemy. I mean, I'm not saying that all jungle maps suck. It's just that I feel the Frontline maps can be a lot more interesting and original. Like, for instance, we have an old map by Crash called Shoreleaf. This was kind of the highlight of Frontline, and people got really excited about the map. He made videos kind of showcasing the new version of his map, talking through how he's making the map and what kind of changes he makes. Then it stopped all of a sudden. He later tried working on a map called Trenchfoot, but it never really got the impact that the Shoreleaf did. There are some other cool jungle maps, like this one. It's like this kind of nice tropical jungle, and the level design is actually really clever. I would have to guess probably Crash's map and this map will get into the Pyro update, and hopefully some more. He's also been working on this TF2 event called TF2 Jam. It's basically this huge charity event where you have 62 hours to make maps, models, videos, artwork, or really anything. Alright, now I know Valve is denying that the Pyro update is community driven, but come on. Jungle maps? Mayan. Boom! How about we have the Pyro update paired with Mayan, and have the Heavy with Frontline? Which one would you choose?
I think I want the Pyro.
Yeah, I know you're gonna pick the Heavy one because, you know, it looks a lot better and everything. I think the items are pretty cool and everything. They kind of fit the style of TF2. I know you're probably thinking, you know, well, where'd you get that idea from, right? Now, I know, like, jungle-themed stuff kind of works with TF2, but come on, like, who wants, like, a discount Indiana Jones kind of style stuff, right? And I'm thinking the old kind of World War II stuff works with TF2 because, you know, the timeline of TF2. The hats for Frontline look pretty good, and I think they'll really fit into TF2 really well. You might recognize some of them because they've actually been accepted in the game, like, as standalones. This one's probably the best in my opinion. Like, come on, look at that, right? Tell me you wouldn't buy this. They also have some really cool custom weapons. Like, here's a couple of them, just like an SMG reskin. They look really cool, and I think some of these are kind of interesting ideas. Because remember, you know, Valve promised, like, hey, you know, new weapons for Pyro and Heavy, so there you go. That'd be pretty cool. I imagine, like, some of these kind of ones here. There hasn't really been much of the project lately, but I think it's still going, kind of. Sort of on the backbone, and, you know, Crash has been busy lately. But even people decided, like, go in the workshop, you know, thumbs up these kind of works, go make some Frontline maps, go make some things, try to, like, revive the project. So, conclusion. What do you think about Frontline? Frontline is a TF2 community project based on World War II. There's a lot of potential, and we need to revive it. And finally, my channel is dying.
Wait, what?